Hi, welcome to this lab. In this lab, I'm going to show you how to create dynamic group and provide access to that dynamic group to one of the storage accounts. I'll also take this opportunity in order to take you through some of the group related settings. Okay, so in order to kickstart everything, let's go into Azure portal and click on Azure Active Directory and click on groups. And let's select one group in order to go through some of the things. And here you can see members. So members are basically the members of the group. It can be users or it can be service principal also. Okay. And owners is somebody who can manage this group. So basically administrator can include some owners here, and the owners can start managing the members in the group, either add members or delete members. Okay. And if you click on group memberships, here you can specify in which groups you want this group to be part of. So basically you can create nested groups. A bunch of groups can be part of another group. Okay. And the next thing is applications. Here you can see all the applications to which the members will get access. So in this case, I have one application, which is application proxy sample. And that application can be accessed by any member of this group. Okay. And here you can see licenses, and also you can assign licenses at a group level. Okay. Generally, when you are working in a corporate environment, you manage licenses at a group level. And as soon as you put a member into that group, this license will get applied. And the next thing is Azure resources. Basically here you can see all the resources to which this group members have access to. Okay. And in terms of monitoring, you can view access reviews and also you can see audit logs. So these are all the settings related to the group. Okay. Now the next thing I want to show you is how to create a dynamic group. In order to do that, first of all, let me go into user and search for Varma Rudra. Basically, in order to create dynamic group, I'm going to change job title of one of the users and use that as a rule within the dynamic group. Okay. You will get to know in a minute why I am doing this. So click on it here. And edit profile, come down. I'm going to change the job title as storage administrator. Okay, let's see. Okay, and let's save. And let me copy this. Now let's start creating dynamic group. Click on groups, click on add. And the group type is going to be security. Group name is storage administrators. Okay. And membership type is dynamic user. You can create dynamic device also, but in this case, I'm using dynamic user. And you can add a dynamic query. Basically, a query can contain rules. Based on that rules and conditions you specify within that rules, the membership of the user to be part of this group will be determined. Okay. So in this case, the rule I'm going to specify is if the job title is equal to storage administrator, we want that particular user to be part of this group. Okay. So add users where job title equals storage administrator. Okay. Very simple. Either you can specify like this, or you can click on advanced rule and specify in the text format. Okay. So add a query and click on create. Now our group has been successfully created. So let's go into the group. Click on storage administrators. And here you can see membership status. See, processing status is not yet updated. And membership last updated also not yet updated. So you need to give a minute or two in order to get this completed. So I'm going to pause this video and come back once this membership evaluation is completed. Now, membership evaluation has been completed and you can see one of the members is Varmarudra. Okay? Now I'm going to show you how to provide access to this particular group to a storage account. So let's go to storage accounts and then click on it and then click on access control and let's add a role assignment. Click on contributor role and then search for that particular group that we created, which starts with storage. Okay. And if you come down here, you can see storage administrators, select that one and save. Okay. That's it. Now we are going to test this assignment to check whether the user of that particular group able to access the storage account or not. Okay. So let me log out. And then log back in with this particular user ID basically. Now go to storage accounts and the user should be able to see and you can click on it and user will be able to see all the management stuff here. Okay, so that's it for this lab. In this lab, I have shown you how to create a dynamic group and provide a role assignment to the dynamic group to one of the storage accounts. And I finally validated the access. Okay. I hope you find this lab useful.